That was really a good experience. It's a bit of a shock to start with when you're doing your basic training. But then I went to Royal Air Force Jurby in the Isle of Man for officer training. And that's quite strenuous, lots of sort of romping around and drilling, and nobody's terribly polite, you're just squaddies. But there was time to get to know the Isle of Man a little, which is a very interesting island. And then the sort of field exercises involved 24 exercises on Snaefell, and so that was strenuous but really quite fun. Then I went to Royal Air Force Debden to do some signals training, which was interesting. I was mainly doing radar there, but then I got posted to a Royal Air Force Wunstorf in Germany, near Hanover, which was in a radio servicing flight. So in fact, I knew nothing at all about the radios. I'd never seen or handled one of the radios whose repair and servicing I was supposed to be supervising. But that seemed to be no great setback. In fact, there were plenty of expert technicians, and I had to deal with the paperwork and so on. But Wunstorf was an interesting place because it had been a German Luftwaffe Air Force station. And unlike in Britain at the time, if you were doing national service there, then you had a lot of people who'd been officers during the war, and the officers' mess had a genuine Royal Air Force atmosphere, which I don't think it would have done if one had been in an Air Force base in Britain. So I really got to enjoy the life, and really was enjoying it very well, so that when my flight lieutenant said, would I like to stay, sort of take a permanent commission rather than leave at the end of 2 years. I still wanted to go on to university. The answer was no, but it didn't seem an odd question. It seemed like a nice alternative to have. And so I was able to travel a good deal in Germany. I bought a car, which gave me endless trouble. I didn't buy it very well, I think. I bought it from a fellow officer on the Air Force base. Proved to be a mistake. It drove down drove a good deal through Germany, and another occasion went down by train to Munich and enjoyed the beer halls of Munich, and then on to Salzburg. And I just happened to be going through Salzburg at the time of the Salzburg Festival. And in those days, it wasn't so well attended as now, so I went and said, anything doing for this evening? And they had the Marriage of Figaro with Dietrich, Fischer-Dieskau and Irmgard, Seefried and Elisabeth, Schwarzkopf, under the direction of von Karajan. So that was quite a good evening just to drop into, as it were. And then on to Vienna, where I got to know the museum, that wonderful museum, the Kunsthistorisches Museum, with the wonderful Bruegel paintings and so on. So I really had some good breaks in Germany and was learning a little bit of German also. So that was really 2 interesting years by way of a break. And then when that finished, I went back to Paris for a couple of months and spent a little bit more time in Paris, which I enjoyed, and then went up to St. John's College in Cambridge in 1958. So that's obviously when one entered into a very different atmosphere, the atmosphere of Cambridge in the late 50s.